I teach students in the Master of Teaching Primary program. My role is to teach mathematics pedagogy for primary students. One of the biggest challenges in my role is to change my students' attitudes towards mathematics. Often they have a bad attitude or suffer from anxiety purely because of their own experiences. The way that I address this is through an active learning approach, providing hands-on experiences and relevant tasks that these students can then take out into primary classrooms. One of the biggest challenges for me in tertiary education is engaging students, particularly in big lecture theatres and in tutorials. What I do to address this is that I draw on my research on student engagement and I apply it to my adult students. I make sure that I'm engaging them on cognitive levels, operative levels and affective levels. So they're thinking hard, they're actually doing things, and they're actually valuing what they're learning. Now, I do this in several ways. I often have problem solving, where students actually have to engage in maths activities. They have to talk to each other and also talk to me. I use a variety of media and a variety of technology to deliver the learning. That some of the technology I use might be from YouTube. Some of it might be animated videos, video snippets of real classrooms, and also the use of iPads to teach. I've been doing some research lately on using iPads in schools and working with teachers, and what I do is I actually take what I learn from that research and deliver it to my students so that when they go out to schools, they will be fully prepared for the technology they find in classrooms.
Yay!
I believe the mixture of theory and practice is ideal. I've studied educational studies in other universities, but here I feel that theory underpins real good practice, and that's what a lot of professors and teachers try to bring here in UWS.
Volume.
In my tutorials, I try and practice what I preach in relation to my work on engagement. Generally, a tutorial would have two or three very rich mathematical tasks. My students engage in those tasks, so they actually do the mathematics, and then we take a step back and talk about how those tasks link to theory and how they link to best teaching practice. We also discuss how we could differentiate those tasks for a different a variety of learning abilities, and we also talk about how we could assess student work in relation to those tasks.
Let's try and put all the reds together and see that they're going to be the same as
the blue. Because we only need 15,
The one that we were doing this morning was looking about shapes, especially shapes from 2D to 3D shapes. For example, this one. So you can talk to the students about the various shapes within the one shape, you can talk about volume, you can talk about mass. So it moves into measurement and it moves into investigating because you're working within a group to construct one physical object.
So the tasks that we engage with in tutorials work towards building a bank of activities for my students. That means that when they go out on prac or when they're actually teaching in the real world, they can draw on those activities, they can adjust them to different grades, and they can use those. It's a great starting point for my students, and that's something that they really appreciate in this course.
The hands-on activities were great. I now feel confident that I can teach mathematics and teach it well.
Catherine is inspirational. Her teaching methods are engaging and she is very approachable. I hope to be the kind of maths teacher she is one day.
The sessions are creatively planned and characterised by her use of current research to demonstrate that mathematics can be taught in a creative and interesting way to primary students.
I take feedback on my units very, very seriously. It's a really important part of teaching and learning. The feedback allows me to refine what I'm doing, so I'm continually improving my work. It also allows me to gauge what the students are thinking about the way that I teach and the sorts of activities that we do in the course.
Volume?
Area.
Area as well, fantastic. So we've covered nearly every aspect of the mathematics syllabus in one task.
I've been getting feedback where students have come back after having used the activities that we've modelled here in the classroom, saying that they used to hate maths and now they love it. And that's contagious. So that carries back on in the classroom, and it's so important that the students in the classrooms are becoming enthusiastic about mathematics.